Greetings. How to poison a dog, or the error in Islam. Please pardon my usage of a Rocky and Bullwinkle subtitle. For those not raised on American TV or too young to see Bullwinkle cartoons, this was a way to introduce an alternative meaning. But how does one poison something? To poison weeds, we simply spray poison on the weeds we desire to kill. But that is because plants do not have choices, or noses to smell something amiss. An animal, however, has senses and the ability to select what it consumes. This is why poison is usually a small portion mixed with a recognizable, appealing bait. And that is just how Islam poisons humanity. Small portions of truth which are appealing are mixed with the poison of error. Let us take a look at many of the various truths Islam uses and the errors that Islam poisons each truth with. Truth 1. There is one God. Monotheism is the category of religion that believes there is only one God. The subtle error which even monotheism is subject to is, which God is the only God? Islam's poison is to claim a false deity is the one true God. The deity Islam demands is the one true God is called Allah. This differs from the other two monotheistic religions who worship a God whose name is Yahweh. Yet Islam goes to great and desperate efforts to claim Allah is the one true God. The remedy or cure for this error is to realize each one may believe there is only one God, but they worship different gods. Truth 2. Because there is one God, polytheism is to be shunned and cursed. In fact, polytheism is an insult to the one true God, because God will not share his glory with another. Isaiah 42:8. I am Yahweh, the Lord. That is my name. I will not share my glory with another or the praise due me with idols. So Islam does present the truth that polytheism is wrong. But Islam's error or poison is to misrepresent Christianity as polytheism. This inoculates and blinds, nay, poisons followers of Islam from ever listening to the accurate truth of what Christians believe. Truth 3. Yahweh, the one true God, made a covenant with Abraham. The covenant was sealed with blood in a ceremony recorded by Prophet Moses in Genesis. A sign of the covenant was circumcision, or a cutting of the foreskin of a man's flesh. Islam practices circumcision, but denies all the terms and details of the covenant. Islam denies that God's eternal covenant is with Isaac. Islam denies that God's eternal covenant gives the land of Israel to the Jews. The cure and remedy for this poisonous lie of Islam is to respect what Prophet Moses revealed in the Torah. Truth 4. Yahweh, the one true God, sent prophets, including Prophet Moses. Clearly, Moses was not the first prophet Yahweh sent to Israel. But Moses was tasked with recording the Torah, or God's message that came before Moses. Islam claims it respects the prophets, including Moses, and their message was from its Allah. This truth actually gets more than one poison injected with it. The first poison is that Moses was a prophet of Islam's Allah, and not Yahweh God that Moses himself spoke of. The second poison is that while Moses is claimed to be a prophet of Islam's Allah, the Torah, which was from Allah, has been changed, corrupted, and essentially lost. This poison is one of Satan's most lethal, and this was the first poison Satan ever used. This is the same poison Satan used against Eve and Adam in the garden. Has God said? Cast doubt on what God said and what God meant by what God said. Deny God even said it, if possible. Has God said? The cure and remedy for this poison was given by Messiah, the Prince. It is written. And that is why this is Satan's most lethal poison. Once Satan casts doubt on God's word, one is attacked with fear of appealing to God's word. Once Satan and Islam convince a Muslim the Torah and Bible are corrupted, they close their minds to the message of the prophets. Pray for Muslims to hear the word of life over and over until it springs forth. Isaiah 55:11, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and shall succeed in the thing for which I sent it. Repeat the word, because God's word is alive, and was even made flesh to reveal God to us. John 1:14, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we saw his glory, glory as of the only begotten from the Father, full of grace and truth. John 14:9, Jesus replied, Philip, I have been with you all this time, and still you do not know me? Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Because the Bible has the life and power of God in the very words, Scripture has the power to crush Satan's jihad of lies. The cure and remedy for Islam's poison is to know and memorize and repeat the Word of God until it is your first answer. Ephesians 4:15. Instead, speaking the truth in love, we will in all things grow up into Christ himself, who is the head. Truth 5. Yahweh, the one true God, sent the Torah through Prophet Moses. Islam does claim the Torah revealed by Moses is divine. In fact, Islam tries to make credentials for Muhammad from the Torah. Surah 7:157. Those who follow the messenger, the prophet who can neither read nor write, whom they find described in the Torah and the gospel which are with them. But credentials from a corrupted book are worthless. And Islam cannot even grasp the logical consequence of their poisonous lie. Truth 6. Yahweh, the one true God, would send a prophet like Moses. Deuteronomy 18:15, the Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among you, from your countrymen. You shall listen to him. Deuteronomy 18:18, I will raise up a prophet like you from among their fellow Israelites. I will put my words in his mouth, and he will tell the people everything I command him. So the truth Islam baits the lie with is that another prophet would come. But the poison in Islam's lie is that the prophet would come from Ishmael, from Arabia. Another poison applied is that Islam refuses to ever read Deuteronomy 18:15, because Deuteronomy 18:15 unambiguously proves the prophet must come from Isaac, from Israel. This central purpose of this poison is to attempt to create credentials for Muhammad. The cure and remedy for this poison is to respect the whole text of the message of Prophet Moses. The prophet would be from Israel, sent to Israel, like Moses, and speak Yahweh's message. Yahweh even defines what like Moses means. Deuteronomy 34:10, Since that time, no prophet has risen in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face, that's point one, for all the signs and wonders which the Lord sent him to perform, that's point two, in the land of Egypt against Pharaoh. That's what like Moses means. So the truth Islam baits the hook with is that a prophet will be sent by God. The poison Islam applies is to redefine like Moses to fit Muhammad in the hope of inventing credentials. The cure and remedy for this lie is to know that Jesus is the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. Truth 7. Jesus is a prophet of God. This truth is just the tip of an infinite iceberg of truth. And Islam repeats the truth that Jesus was a prophet with zeal and volume. But nearly every other detail about Jesus is poisoned by denial, error, and direct fraud. Jesus came as a prophet of Yahweh. Islam's poison is that Jesus was a prophet of Allah and Muhammad's religion, Islam. Jesus was the prophet of Deuteronomy 18 that Yahweh sent. Islam's poison is to deny Jesus was the prophet of Deuteronomy 18 because it desperately needs credentials for Muhammad. Jesus was the Son of God sent as a prophet. Islam's poison is to deny Jesus was the Son of God because the Allah of Islam has no son. Jesus was the Son of God who came as a prophet. Islam's poison is to deny Jesus was anything more than a mere human prophet. Jesus was the Son of God who came as a prophet. Islam's poison is to declare Allah cannot have a son. Allah needs no son. Truth 8. Jesus was the Messiah promised by God. Islam repeats the truth that Jesus was the Messiah with zeal and volume. The poison of Islam is to deny that Messiah was to be the Son of God. And this is something even the high priest of Israel knew. Matthew 26:63. But Jesus remained silent. Then the high priest said to him, I charge you under oath by the living God. Tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God. Truth 9. The God of the prophets is all-powerful. Islam claims it is a truth of Islam that its Allah is all-powerful. The poison of Islam is then to list many things its Allah cannot do. Allah cannot enter his creation. This is why Allah cannot come to visit his temple as the prophets of Yahweh foretold. Allah could not protect or preserve his Torah or gospel against corruption by the Jews. This is why Allah's unchangeable word, quote-unquote, of the Torah was changed and corrupted. Allah cannot see or tell the future. This is why Allah could not see Jesus working miracles would be misunderstood as Jesus being God. In truth, no one thinks Jesus is God just because Jesus worked miracles. Allah cannot see or foretell the future. This is why Allah could not see faking the crucifixion would cause Christianity. Islam's error and poisonous lie is that Jesus was not killed and was not even crucified. The Allah of Islam only deceived all who witnessed the event, making it appear as if Jesus were. These are a significant but not exhaustive list of the truths Islam poisons with error. Once swallowed, Islam delivers the fatal lie that damns souls. Jesus did not redeem mankind, as the prophets promised God would do. Once you realize Satan's jihad of deception and poisonous lies is mixed in with truths, you will be better equipped to stand firm on the pure truth of the message of the prophets. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.